describe cold email on a lot of my consulting calls and client calls as smashing your head against a brick wall over and over again until that brick wall breaks. Some people say that's a little bit of an aggressive metaphor, but it's true. Most of cold email, especially when you're just starting out, is creating a bunch of subject lines to see what gets the highest open rates, creating a bunch of different versions of an email body to see what resonates with people, trying different offers, trying a bunch of different things to see what's actually gonna sell. And then once you start selling, you win. That's it. And I'll link down below to a sheet where we go through all of the stats that you should be looking for in your cold email campaigns. It's a cold email testing plan. And in today's video, I wanna run through the sequel to that video. Here is the actual tracking sheet that we use at Experiment 27 to optimize our cold email campaigns to make sure we get the highest meeting book rate possible. And you can use it too. There's a download to this one as well in the description. Let's run through it. I like to say this is pretty straightforward, but only one consulting client has understood it off the bat without me having to explain it. So I'll go through it in detail here. The goal of this doc is to get your cold emails opened, replied to, and have meetings on the calendar. So this is a simple doc to do that. The first thing I recommend doing before you jump into this sheet is you need to decide what niche you're going after, super specific as well. So not e-commerce, it's gotta be makeup, right? Not consumer packaged goods, it has to be soda. Something that specific, and you can write those niches in here. I would test one thing at a time. This doc right now is set up to test subject lines. So we're selling to hair salons. Some of these subject lines, especially these emojis, have had very high open rates, 60 to 80% open rates in some niches. Some niches they don't work at all, which is why we're testing them here. But feel free to use these subject lines as well. I recommend sending 50 cold emails a day if you're customizing the first lines, which I also recommend doing. And I'm probably gonna do another video on how to write first lines if you want it. So leave a comment down below if you want an in-depth video on how to write the first line of an email. The next step, once you have the subject lines in here, is to write out the number of emails you send. If we're sending 50, it's 10 per subject line. You can send these all at once. The goal is to get the subject line over 80%. So you'll go into Yesware, Mailshake, Quickmail, whatever you're using to send the emails, and you'll pull this data manually from there. So for instance, for this scissor emoji, we got 6 opens on 10 sends. It'll automatically calculate as 60%. Let's say we got 8 opens, and you see this changes here. So 8 opens, we got 3 replies, and let's say we got 1 meeting. And we'll continue to track. 10% meeting book rate, it's pretty good, it's in line. And what this will allow you to do is see how all the emails are doing. I run all of our consulting clients through this. We run all of our X27 clients through this as well, because at a glance you can see how the emails are doing and where you need to improve. For instance, let's say this is actual data. This is test data, but let's say this is actual data. Hair salons with this scissor emoji got an 80% open rate, which I would say is in line with where it needs to be. So I would throw all of these subject lines out, and we would never use these again. We win with scissors, so the next week, we're gonna test all scissor emojis, and we have to test something else. So the way I would diagnose this is the niche is fine, because we're getting an 80% open rate. That means the leads are of high quality, the email addresses are fine, the subject line works. So we'll send 50 with this subject line, and we'll change something else about the email. Let's assume this holds. Usually it'll drop off and then you'll have to write more subject lines. But let's assume this number holds and we get an 80% open rate consistently. Then what we're doing is the baseline. So we sent the same email and we'll get 3 replies and we'll get 1 meeting. Then what we want to do is once the email's getting open, rewrite the email and make sure it's clear what we're doing. So we can try to get the number of replies up. From there, let's say we test 4 or 5 different versions of the email, right? We've got 4 more sends left. We test 4 different versions of the email, and then you'll see reply rate change. So let's say this version got a 4, this one got a 1, this one got a 2, this one got a 1. We know that this 4 is winning, but you'll also see sometimes that you get 4, but something else is wrong with the email and you might get 0 meetings. So this doc will help you diagnose exactly what's wrong with your email. Something is wrong if you get 4 replies and 0 meetings, but 3 replies and 1 meeting on another one. So I would look at what this email is and we would scale this email. If you have any more questions on the testing strategy, let me know. Leave a comment down below. If you want this exact document, there is a link in the description. If you want a team to run through this system with your company, this is all we do at Experiment 27 all day, every day. We help agencies get in touch with and book meetings with and close deals with large enterprise clients. Check that out at experiment27.com. If you want to work one-on-one with me to implement this system at your company, you can book a consulting call. It's an hour-long call where we'll dive deep, we'll run through this whole process, write your cold email campaigns, everything you need for your company. That is over at experiment27.com/consulting. And if you have written a business book and you want it turned into a documentary, you want to break away from the normal corporate video that everyone's trying to create for you, go over to loreliapictures.com. We'd love to work together. I'm Alex Berman. Thanks.